is what has been the most important in the Celtics' turnaround?
I would say of all those factors, I think the Gerald Green factor is the biggest one, and here's why. Having Gerald in that starting lineup really spaced the floor, and it gave Chicago something that they had to, frankly, react to, and they have not been able to do that. Gerald is getting shots, or Isaiah's getting shots, or whoever is on that in the floor in that starting five is getting great looks. And that, again, you look at these games here in Chicago, Boston has been open the game with 14-4 runs with Gerald in that starting lineup, and that has set the tone for the rest of the night. So Gerald, certainly, his presence with that starting unit has been a huge factor in Boston getting games 3 and 4.
Okay, so Drapes,
let me answer this with Felger.
It feels like that's green teaming, because if you say it's the Rondo injury, that's taking something away right from the Celtics. But isn't that where this started?
No, it clearly is the Rondo injury, because the Celtics offense, they only scored 104 points. It's not like they went out and scored 120 points. Defensively, they are so much better now than they were the first two games. Rajon Rondo controlled the first two games.
He picked you apart the first couple of games.
He was the best player out there the first couple of games. The Chicago Bulls are using their fifth point guard, Isaiah Cannon. He's in the game now. And so let's not downplay this Rondo situation. Sure, Gerald Green was great tonight, gave them a boost offensively, but I think their defense has been better because there's no Rajon Rondo out
okay
there.
Real quick, Rajon Rondo was fined $25,000 for trying to trip Jay Crowder. This guy still is a little weasel putz. I don't like the guy one bit, Rajon Rondo, but he gets fined $25,000. Sherrod, I still think he's coming back this series. Am I nuts?
You know what? When he got fined at $25,000, there was not a shocked soul in the NBA landscape, because this was more of a reputation thing than anything else. Rondo clearly stuck that foot out there. At least he had the smarts to put out the knee that had surgery. Because if you would have put the left one out, then you would have definitely known what was up. So at least he was smart enough to at least make it look like he was sort of kind of stretching. But we all know what he was trying to do.
Okay, I think he
comes back.
Yeah, I think there's a good chance he comes
back.
Look
at the timetable. They said 7 to 10 days. Wednesday will be 7 days yep after the injury occurred.
I wouldn't be surprised if he's out there on Wednesday.
Yeah, I wouldn't be. Their season hangs in the balance right here. If you're Rondo, you know you want to get out there. Knowing him with the elbow, with the ACL, he's played through all that. He'll play through a little thumb injury or whatever it is.